This video is about x and y components of vectors. All vectors have what's called an x component and a y component. So this is vector A. I'm going to be using this as an example. The x component is how far in the horizontal direction the vector travels. So if this is vector A, this is its x component right here. And its y component is how far in the vertical direction the vector travels. So that would be the y component of vector A. That's how far in the up-down direction it goes. So we call these x and y components because they go along the x and y axis of a graph. So we can have x components and we can have y components. And that really just means that they're pointing along the x or y axis. X and Y components are themselves vectors. They also have directions. Like vector A is going up and to the right, so its X component points to the right and its Y component points up. And we have this special label for vectors that are X and Y components of other vectors. If the original vector is A, the X component of A will be AX and the Y component will be AY. So we could draw these like this. Just as a real-world example, we could imagine a bird flying up in a certain direction, and the vector of the bird's motion, I'm going to call vector A. The x component of the bird's motion, AX, could be thought of as how far along the ground the bird's shadow traveled as it moved. And the y component of the bird's motion would be how high into the air the bird went. So x and y components can have real physical meanings in addition to the original vector that they're making up. Even if you have a perfectly horizontal or perfectly vertical vector, we can still say that it technically has an x and y component. The x component is how far it goes in the horizontal direction, and so if this is 5 meters perfectly horizontally, that means the x component is just 5 meters. It's the same as the original vector. And we would just say that the y component is 0 here because it's not going up or down at all. So this would be like the bird moving 5 meters along the ground. If we were to ask for its x component, we would be really asking for how far its shadow moved along the ground, which we know would be 5 meters. And if we asked for its y component, we'd really be asking how high into the air did it go, and we know that that would be 0 meters. There are two general rules for x and y components and how they relate to a vector. You can see, first of all, that they actually obey the rules of vector addition, the tip-to-tail method, and the x component plus the y component as vectors, if we're adding them using vector math rather than regular math, the tip-to-tail method means that the x and y components always add together to be the original vector. So a vector is equal to the sum of its x and y components. So that's the first rule. You'll also notice that no matter how we draw the x component and no matter how we draw the y component, they're always going to form a right triangle with the original vector. So as another example, if we have this vector here and this is its x component and this is its y component, we can see that when we put them together in vector addition, they're equal to the original vector. So that will always be true. One common mistake with this rule is that students sometimes assume that the numbers themselves add up to be the total of the vector. So if we imagine that the x component is 3 and the y is 4, that overall vector using the Pythagorean theorem will be 5. It won't be 7. So it's not that the scalars add together, it's that the vectors using vector addition add together to make that total vector. So I can see here that the scalar quantities look like this, which means that this rule does not work for scalars. It only works when you're using the full vector and the tip-to-tail method to find the answer. So just adding the scalars together won't work. You may have noticed, however, that no matter how we draw vectors, their x and y components always form perfect right triangles with them when we draw them, because the x and y components are by definition at 90 degree angles to each other. So because of the Pythagorean theorem, that means that the x and y components will always be related to the full vector using the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So this will always be true. And if I rearrange this into a general rule, The total vector is going to be equal to the square root of the squares of its own x and y component if I draw it as a scalar rather than a vector like this. So if we just focus on the scalar quantities, this will always be true for the x and y components of a vector. This is just a summary of what we've talked about, and that's what you need to know about x and y components.